So in this video, we just shall look at one of the shorting techniques. So shorting techniques, we have multiple number of shorting techniques, but today we are just going to look at a bubble shorting algorithm. So what is the purpose of this particular algorithm is that for the given list of elements, what it does is that it just aligns or it just assigns in an ascending order manner, which means that the smaller number will be in the front of the list and the largest number will be in the last of the list. Likewise, it will be present as an ascending order, right? So here what we have to look at is, so your bubble sort is an example of a simple brute force algorithm, right? So brute force algorithm, we just know it, right? So there is no procedure which is being followed over here. So likewise, your bubble sort algorithm also just, it is a simple plain old fashion, such a way that it just takes the couple of adjacent elements, compares them. If it is in order, it just leaves as such. If it is not in order, what it does is that just swaps those two elements and then moves on to the next element. So here we are just going to perform the operation in the form of passes. So passes are nothing but the number of steps which we are going to compare, and then we are just going to interchange. So for example, here for n number of elements, we will be doing n minus 1 number of passes, and then inside n number of passes, so inside each and every pass there will be n minus 1 number of steps. Okay, so here you will be having n minus 1 number of passes and then n minus 1 number of steps for performing each and every passes, right? So this is how we will be doing it. So it is a simple straightforward brute force approach for solving the problem. Okay, so what we do is that we just shall look at it with the help of an example. So I'll just write down an example. Okay, so just consider this list. Okay, so we just have said that we are going to perform around n minus 1 number of passes, right? So in the pass 1, what we are doing is that we are just going to take the given list, which is nothing but 89, 45, 68, 90, 29, right? So here what we do is that we just take the first two elements. Okay, so we just call it as the take the first element and compare it with the adjacent element. So for example, I just take 89, I just compare it with the adjacent element 45, right? So here what happens is that it is not in the order. So whenever it is not in the order, what I will do is that I'll just perform swap operation. So I'm just performing swap over here. So what happens is that, so 45 has been come over here, 89, 68, 90, and then 29, right? So right now what we have to do is that we just have to compare the next two elements. So what we do, we just take the 89 and then we just compare it with 68. So again, here also it is not in an order. What we have to do is that we just have to perform the swap operation. So once after swapping, what we get is we just get around 45, 68, 89, 90, and then 29, right? So right now we just have to compare the next two elements, which is nothing but 89 with 90. I'm just comparing. So this is the adjacent element, right? So here what happens is that here the condition is something like the second adjacent element is greater. So there is no need for you to swap. So we just simply continue. Okay, so in the for the next step, what we have to do is that we just have to compare the next two adjacent elements, which is nothing but 90 and 29. We have to compare, right? So I'm just comparing 90 and 29. So what has happened over here is that, so if you just take a closer look, it is again not in order. What we have to do is that we just have to swap, right? So this is step number 1, step number 2, step number 3, step number 4. So for 5 number of elements, we have to perform 4 number of steps to obtain it. Okay, so here as said, so your final output will be something like 45, 68, 89, 29, and 90. So this is the output of the single pass. Okay, so similarly, we just said that in a simple bubble sort algorithm, we have to go with in the form of n minus 1 number of passes, right? So here we are having 5 elements, we have to go with 4 passes. So first pass is completed. So what we have to do is that we just have to move on with the next pass, right? So pass 2, what we do, we just take the shorter list which is being given from the pass 1, which is nothing but 45, 68, 89, 29, and 90. Okay, so if you just take a closer look at this particular algorithm, we just know that. So the greatest number has been bubbled to its position. So which means that, so once after each and every pass is completed, the greatest number in the particular list will move to its end. So which means that it will be moving on to its original position. Okay, so and there is no need for you to check the particular number again. So there is no need for you to check 90 again over here. So what you have to do is that you just have to check for these four elements. So you have to perform three number of steps. Okay, so in step number one, what we do is that we just compare 45 and 68, right? So it is in order. So we just have to perform a simple continuum, right? So 45, 68, 89, 29, and 90, right? So here the next step is that we just have to compare 68 with 89. So here it is also a simple continue statement. Why? Because it is in order, right? So the third step, what we do is that we just compare the next two elements, which is nothing but 29 and 89. Okay, so 29 and 89, I'm just comparing it. So once after comparing, what we have obtained is that it is not in order. So what we have to do is that we just have to swap the elements, right? So once after swapping, the output of pass 2 will be something like 45, 68, 29, 89, and 90. So which means that once after two passes, the last two elements are in its position. So there is no need for you to check 90, and also there is no need for you to check for 89 in the second pass, right? Sorry, in the third pass. So I'm just moving on to the pass 3. Okay, so moving on to pass 3, what happens is that I just consider the list which is being obtained from the previous pass. So 49, 68, 29, 89 and 90. So we just know that 89 and 90 is already being shorted. Okay, so what we do, we just take the first two elements, 45 and 68, we just take it and then we just compare them. So once we compare them, we just get it like there is no need for you to change. So we just have a continue, right? Okay, so once after performing, 45, 68, 29, 89, and 90, is it in position? So for the next operation, what we have to do, is that we just have to check are 68 and 29. So once we check 68 and 29, here it is not in order, we just have to perform swap. So the final output will be something like 45, 29, 68, right? 89 and 90. So this is how your pass 3 ends. Okay, so right now all these three elements are in shorted order, right? So moving on to the pass 4, so which is nothing but the last pass in our list. So I'm just moving on to pass 4, right? So in pass 4, I just take the output, or I just take the list from the previous one. So 45 29 68 89 and 90, right? So what I do is that I just check the first two elements, right? So here it is not in order, I have to perform the swapping operation. So what happens? 29 45 68 89 and 90, right? So here we just have completed our pass, and then we just have completed our steps. So once after completing our steps, and once after completing each and every pass, we just know that this particular list is a shorted list. So this is how we just perform our bubble sort operation. So right now what we shall do is that we just shall look at the algorithm for it. So algorithm starts with a keyword algorithm, right? So bubble sort, I just acronym it to BS, bubble sort, right? So here what we are given with, so we are just given with a list of n elements starting with 0 to n minus 1, right? So here the description of it, so it is nothing but implementation of bubble sort. So I'm just going to implement bubble sort, so I just write it as implementation of bubble sort. So here I just give an input, so input is nothing but an array of n unshorted elements. So here it is going to be an array of n unshorted elements, and then you will be getting an output. So output will be something like this, similarly an array of n shorted outputs. Okay, so here it is a simple straightforward method. So I'll just perform a looping operation of I is equals to 0 to n minus 2. So why am I giving n minus 2? So 0 generally it starts with 0 to n minus 1. We just know that we are going to have n minus 1 number of passes. So I'm just giving it as such, right? So for j is equals to 0 to n minus 2 minus I 2. So if a of j plus 1 is less than a of j, so what we do, so we just perform a simple swap operation. So swap, we will be swapping a of j and a of j minus 1. Okay, so it is a simple swapping operation. We will just interchange the element. So this is your algorithm, right? So we just shall look at the complexity also. So while looking at the complexity, we just know that we are having around two for loops, and this is going to be your basic operation. Okay, so I'll just write out the complexity such a way that taking the outermost for loop, so summation, I just put I is equals to 0 to n minus 2. So then taking the innermost for loop for j is equals to 0 to n minus 2 minus I, and then which is equals to 0, right? So if we just simplify, if we just expand this equation, we will be getting something like summation I is equals to 0 to n minus 2, n minus 2 minus I. So whatever the thing is there, 0 to n minus 1, we will be implementing it as such, right? So minus 0 plus 1, so it is a simpler summation expansion series, right? So similarly, summation I is equals to 0 to n minus 1. So you have to implement it. We will be getting n minus 1 minus I. So plus minus will be cancelled, right? So once after doing it, so just try to expand, implement this also. So you will be getting like for value of I, n plus n minus 1. Right, so it will be keep on expanding like this. So you will be getting it as n to n plus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so you will be getting something like n square minus n divided by 2. So taking out our big O notation, so we will be having the maximum notation out of it. So big O of n will be, you will be taking the greatest value, which is nothing but it will be tending to n square. Okay, so here the complexity of the algorithm will be something like big O of n square. Why? Because is that we are just having, we just have to take the greatest degree out of it, and then we just shall place it. So this is how you will be calculating the complexity. So bubble shot's complexity will be big, so theta of n square, right?